Good morning, all of you. Welcome to our online class. Today we are going to study about living things and non-living things. What are living things and what are non-living things? This topic is one of the most important as well as vital topic in our day-to-day life. Living things. Anything that is living in our environment is known as living thing. Now you must be having questions and doubt that why am I teaching this topic? Yes, because today in the scientific world, where people, in this modern world, where people are more into science and technology, where their science has increased in developments, we have come to have known about very much inventions as well as acknowledgements. Now, you can see here what is living things. The question, the topic as it suggests, living things and non-living things, what is living thing? You might have questions in your mind, living things. Yes, we know. This is a very normal topic. But to study it vast, it has a vast topic beyond itself. Living things. Anything in this world that is living is called living thing. Now, what is living? Anything around us, anything that moves, anything that grows, anything that has feelings, that are known as living things. Now, I have written the meaning of living thing. What are living things? Things that grow or move or reproduce, breathe, are called as living things. Now, what are the characteristics of living things? What are the characteristics? Okay, how do we differentiate whether a particular thing is a living thing or non-living thing? You can see here, living things have certain characteristics, like they breathe. Breathing is one of the most important characteristics in spite of them moving or in spite of not moving. Okay, here living things include plants and animals. But have you ever seen plants breathing? No, we cannot see plants breathing. So how do we know that a plant is a living thing or not? Okay, we will come back afterwards, but then there are certain characteristics like moving. Animals move. We are also animals, but we are social animals. Now, eating or consumptions. We eat, animal eats, even the microbes, microorganisms eat, but we do not know, we haven't seen that plants eat or not, or how, what is the mode of their consumption, we do not know at all. So, how did people come to know that a plant is a living thing or not? We will come to that later on. But then, feelings. We all feel, even animals feel hot, cold. The feeling of hotness or coldness, like you have studied in your last chapter about sense organs, that human have different sense organs, 5 sense organs, which helps them to feel emotions as well as it helps to feel the particular climatic conditions, hot or cold. Then living things grow, both plant and animals. From this particular characteristics, we can come to know that a particular plant or plant is a living thing because plant grow. Then there is reproduction. What is reproduction? Reproduction is a process of giving out our same kind to another species or another generation is known as reproduction. Suppose a mother gives birth to a baby, or when you eat an apple, at that time you can see that inside the apple fruit there are seeds inside it, or any of the fruits or vegetables that you can see, or you have cut it or you have eaten it, you can see that there are seeds inside it. From that seed there is the process of germination if it is planted properly. Then we can come from, now coming back later to the topic about plants. How do we know that a particular thing or a plant is a living thing? There were certain researches to find out a plant is a living thing or not. How did we come to understand is the plant is living thing or not? With the help of growing. A small plant grows from a herb, it grows to a shrub. From a shrub, it grows to a tree. Even plants cook food. How do plants cook food? Plants cook food with the help of photosynthesis. What is photosynthesis? This is much higher topic than what you are going to study. The process of photosynthesis is when that plants take the help of sunlight. With the help of sunlight, plants cook food with the help of water as with the help of air. We all should know that plants give out oxygen. what we do is we give out carbon dioxide. We need oxygen to take in the air in the morning, early in the morning, or whenever we breathe, taking in a deep breath. At that time, we have seen that we need oxygen. We need fresh oxygen in order to make us living, in order to make our body lungs moving. So now, what we are going to understand that plants need carbon dioxide to cook food for themselves. That process is called photosynthesis. Now, we have already studied this major six things, this major three topics, characteristics about plants. Now we are going to study about non-living things. What are non-living things? Non-living things are the things that do not grow, they do not move, they do not have life. It's called non-living things. Okay, how do we characterize non-living things? We have already studied about living things. Now we are going to study about non-living things. What are non-living things? Non-living things, they do not move, they do not do certain things, anything. They do not breathe, they do not move, they do not reproduce. They are of its own kind. Suppose you can see this blackboard. It's not moving. It does not have any feeling. It does not have any characteristics that help us to think that it could be living thing, because it does not grow or it does not show any change. Unlike the blackboard or like the board, whatever we do, it stays very pale. Okay, now things. What are the characteristics? They do not move, as I've already said. They do not breathe. They do not grow. And validity of things are not certain. Like living things. Living things have this age limit. That is a characteristic of living thing. The living thing live up to a certain time, certain life. But non-living thing can persist for many and many years. We do not know for how many years they can stay. But the fact is that living things have certain age limit, whereas non-living things do not have certain age limit. A stone can be there forever, a mountain can be there forever. Now coming back, like I've already said about mountain, now coming back to our next topic, that is man-made things and natural things. What are man-made things and natural things? Man-made things are the things that are made by man. It can be categorized as living thing also. Non-living thing also. Now see, what are the examples of non-living things? You can see chair, table, pencil, books, things that do not move, things that we make are non-living things. And now talking about man-made things, things that are made by man, this house, your electric fan or electricity, things that have been constructed by man is known as living thing. Now, natural things. What are natural things? Natural things are the things that are made by God. What are the things that are made by God? God has been so kind to us that God has made different things, living things as well as non-living things. Living things, God made us, God made animals, God made plants, but God made non-living things also. What are the things that God made? If we go to see, God made many non-living things like land, like soil, like water, mountains, rivers, even sun. But the thing is that we should not forget that there are different things man can do, or there are different things even animal or birds have been helping the nature. Whatever we get from our nature, or whatever God has created, this beautiful nature, the greenery around us, that comes into what? That comes into natural things. Things made by God, nature, is called natural things. For example, earth, for example, sun, the blue sky, or even the birds are made by nature. Now, what we've come to know from this chapter, that we have to save our environment, we have to make it clean and nice, irrespective of what, who has done it. Yes, human are going into certain development without any limits, but that does not mean that we somewhere harm the nature or we somewhere destruct it by our own means and by our own benefits. So I hope from this chapter that you have understood that we should take care of our natural resources, as well as we should take care of our man-made things and not litter around here and there. So thank you, have a great day, goodbye.